Now, we are moving to the second theorem. Okay, we have done for the uniqueness of matrix theorem number 1, and now we are having theorem 2. Okay, so the theorem 2. Theorem 2 says what? Theorem 2 says, if A and B are the two invertible matrices. Okay, theorem 2. If A and B, invertible matrix of same order. If A and B, be invertible matrix of same order, then I am going to write a condition which you are already aware of the condition. Then AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Now, how you were aware of this? Because this was a property for the transpose of a matrix. There we have done it, that transpose of AB, combined transpose of AB is always equal to B transpose A transpose. Okay. So now, same property for the inverse, for the uniqueness also. Okay. So let's prove it. We just have to prove. Now, for the proving part, what we are using? We are using the invertible matrix, some few properties. What we have used, that A inverse into A is also I. Okay. I into A inverse is also A. Okay. So now we are having AB and inverse of AB is equal to identity matrix. AB and inverse of AB is equal to identity matrix, and this you can say by definition of inverse. By definition of inverse of matrix. Now, after this step, now what we can write it? AB into AB inverse is equal to I. Now, pre-multiplying both sides by A inverse is equal to A inverse I. Now, remember one thing, multiplying I, A with I or I with A is one and the same thing. Now, if we are multiplying A inverse in the right from the extreme left side, then here also it should be in the extreme left hand side. Okay. If for I it hardly matters, but for other matrix it do matters. If we are multiplying A inverse on the extreme right side, then it should be on the extreme right side of the another matrix. Okay. So here we can write by pre-multiplying on both sides. Okay. Now, A inverse A, B, AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Okay. So, what we have done, we have opened the bracket. A inverse A, B, AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Now here what we have used? We have used associativity for the associativity. What we have used? AI is equal to A for this part. Now A inverse A, B, AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Again, what we are having? A inverse A, this becomes identity matrix. IB, AB inverse is equal to A inverse. And what we have used? A inverse A is equal to identity matrix. Property of inverse. Okay. Same thing. Whatever it was written here, we can write property of inverse. You can use it if you want to use it. You can write it property. Property of inverse. Now we are having IB, AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Then now IB means what? Only I. Now only B AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Okay. We are having IB is equal to B. IB means identity matrix multiplying by a matrix. Okay. So now we are having B inverse B, AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Okay. Again, pre-multiplying by B inverse to both sides. Pre-multiplying by B inverse to both sides. Again, now B inverse into B is what? I. B inverse into B is identity matrix. Now AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Okay. Now what reason we have used? We have used B inverse B is equal to I. Property of inverse. Okay. So now finally what is left? Finally we are left with AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Proved. So these were the two theorems. These were the two theorems for the uniqueness of a matrix. First theorem was using A. If A is an invertible matrix, B and C are the inverse, then we can prove it that B is equal to C. Okay. And the second and the most important result. Okay. We will be having number of questions on this theorem. Okay. And the theorem is AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse.